Welcome back, Dr. Umar Addo, a member of the PDP and also Executive Secretary, Alternative Policy Perspectives and Strategy, is still with us in the studio. Doctor, you've talked about some of the government's role in trying to reorient Nigerians and perhaps, you know, people looking less towards government and looking at becoming less desperate, you know, to seize power. Now, we know that this is going to take a while. We don't know when this is going to be achieved, especially when you see this, the mammoth crowds we see at rallies. And to ensure that, you know, each party is able to accept the results that will come out of the elections, we've seen, a peace committee come up and, you know, try to ensure that, you know, parties make a commitment to peace. But in recent times, we have seen a threat by your party to withdraw from, you know, the peace agreement over comments made by, the governor of Kaduna State, which some people say have been misinterpreted. How would you say, you know, would you say that any circumstance justifies the withdrawal of any party from a peace agreement?
If the party feels that the ruling party is determined to cause mayhem, of course, the party will have to withdraw. Because it will withdraw not because it is going to cause crisis, but it will withdraw because it does not any longer have confidence in the government. Now, as for what the Kaduna State governor said, as you put it, maybe it has been misinterpreted. I saw it. There is no misinterpretation in it. He is talking about foreign interference. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't understand what foreign interference means, that foreign observers, that they cannot come and observe and then make comments, write their report, opinion.
I'm not holding brief for the governor. I think it has to be very clear. I'm not holding brief for the governor of Kaduna State. But in diplomacy, we know that there is a difference between observation and interference. Interference is not allowed by any... Interfering in the sovereignty of a country is not allowed under any grounds, except with permission from the United Nations. And even then, United Nations only intervenes under very, very strict circumstances. Now, if the governor was talking about intervention, would you, as a Nigerian, welcome intervention in any way?
Of course, I will not welcome interference into our domestic affairs, certainly. But why did he have to make this statement? Because there was no... It was statements made by Britain and the United States and the EU on the Chief Justice
suspension
issue. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that does not amount to interference. It's an opinion expressed on an issue. But when did we even start on that? Because in 1966, there was actual interference in our affairs. Without that interference, would Nigeria have been today as a sovereign country? When in 1966, there was a counter-military coup, and the group said they wanted to separate the country, Araba, led by late General Murtala Mohammed, the United States ambassador and the British ambassador were in the meetings with these military officers. What kind of interference is more than that? And it is because of this interference that Nigeria remained one country.
Will we welcome such an interference again?
If it is for the benefit of the country, at that time we were also a sovereign nation. 1966, we were a sovereign nation. We accepted that. Why? Because the situation called for it. Where is situation? Things must be determined as per circumstances and determining the very situation. So if a situation determines for a direct interference, of course, for the benefit of the country, of course you will have to take it.
Wouldn't some people argue that that is subjective? Who determines what is for the benefit of the country? Is it external powers or those who are on the inside?
In 1966, it was those that were inside that said, look, let's bring the British and an American ambassador.
Which is a different situation. If you invite them, it is very different from they, you know, coming in by themselves to say, we think something is wrong here and would like to intervene.
It was not a government that invited them. It was a group of people in the country that were doing certain things that felt that we need the support of these people, we need them to participate in this issue. So they went and invited them. It was not the government. So everything is determined by the circumstances of its being.
So, I mean, the government of the day has said we have listened to his explanation because Malam Nasser Rufai was given the room to clarify what he meant, what he said in the earlier statement. And he says he still stands by his words. The presidency says they're satisfied with what he said. Are you satisfied with the clarification he made?
Well, I don't know. I really do not want to go into that because actually he just retracted.
And in any case,
in any case,
yes.
You don't even say so. Even where there is such interference, you don't express a position of violence as the response to an interference. Mm. He should have done it. We should do it within the ambit of the law. If they interfere, then what are we going to do? Maybe we submit a complaint to the United Nations. We take it within the rule of law. But when you take it on a position of violence, as he said it, they will go in the bodies of body bags. That is to say, they will be killed and put inside the body bags and sent over. That is the worst statement somebody can make. There is no justification for that in any way.
Mm. But do you also think that, I mean, even despite, you know, what you have said now, do you think your party would be, you know, justified if it pulls out of peace talks, given just how charged the environment is? Don't you think that one party, at least two, ought to show commitment to the peace agreement that they have signed?
Having put it this way, I think I will take it, yeah. Maybe the PDP should grow beyond the APC. Where APC is preaching violence, PDP should, you know, try to say, no, we will go it the peaceful manner. We will not withdraw, we will persuade, we will convince, and we will make it peaceful. I think, having put it this way, PDP is not going to withdraw in any case, but you don't make statements like the one made by the Kaduna State Government.
You have confirmation. Under any circumstances. You have confirmation that the PDP will not withdraw from the peace agreement?
I don't have confirmation, but I know PDP. PDP will not withdraw. PDP has stake in this country as much as even more than APC.
Mm. What do you hope to see on election day? I mean, what are your expectations for the presidential elections, which will flag off on the, which will start on the 16th?
I expect to see Nigerians piling up, going to vote, and at the end of the vote, you know, it will be counted, and PDP will again, you know, get the highest score.
Every party expects their party to win.